good and perfect gift. And let me tell you, and one of those gifts not only is life, but the gift of knowledge.
Yeah.
Now he gave it to the man and woman in the garden. He said, I'm going to give you this gift.
Yeah.
Now every tree that you see in this garden, yes, he gave us knowledge right there.
Yeah.
So you got all these trees, but these two, which is what is good and evil,
do not
touch these trees. And from the day you touch thou shalt surely, amen, surely die. Yeah. Didn't he tell them that?
Yes, yeah.
Yeah. So in other words, he knew what was best for them.
Yeah.
So the garden was their home.
Yeah.
Amen. So he gave them this command, say, I want you to get in here, I want you to replenish, multiply, yes, and be fruitful.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. If you obey my commandments, amen, then good gonna follow you.
Well,
rest of your days. A lot of times, and sometimes even the knowledge that they even use that knowledge, and then the devil come in and want to try to twist it up and try to make it work against God himself.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if God has said if you do such a thing, you're gonna die. No, you will not die.
Mm-hmm.
Now, she already had everything coming. All she had to do is keep on track of what he told her. He said, now, if we eat this, we're gonna die.
Yeah.
But then going against that, a lot of times we can be a foolish thing because you look at, go back to James 1 and 2. Oh. My brother, count it all joy when you fall into divers temptation.
Mm-hmm.
Knowing this, that the trying of your faith, amen, working, amen, patience.
All right.
And let me tell you, he said in verse 13, he said, let no man say when he is tempted,
mm-hmm,
I am tempted of God, for
right,
God cannot be tempted with
right,
evil,
right,
neither
right,
tempt he any man. No, he did not tip you against your will or cause you to do certain things. He don't cause you to do things that are going to harm your life. So the word, he brings, amen, every good and perfect gift, amen, comes, amen, from God.
Yes, Lord.
We're blessed with the gift of knowledge.
Yes.
Amen. We're blessed, amen, with peace.
Mm-hmm.
We're blessed, amen, with shelter, food, clothing. All such that we have. So when I say every good gift comes from him, because let me tell you, man invents things, but God creates things. And then also man's ability, amen, before we even go to the classroom, but man, we pick it up in the book, so we got those that are educated in carpentry. Say they go there and learn how the carpentry trade, know how to put these buildings together, build big fine buildings, but going back, did not God give Noah knowledge?
Yes, he did.
Go there and build me an ark.
Oh, yeah.
Build me an ark, and I want you to make it a gopher wood.
Yeah.
Because the end of the world is going to come.
Yeah.
He said, now this is how you're going to make it. I'm going to be the architect here.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Every good and perfect gift of knowledge first comes from God.
Well,
amen.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
And so Noah follows instructions. Okay, this way you want it, this way you want it, it's deck by deck, this height. This leverage here,
yes,
and then somewhere. Well, why do you want to build it so high? Two stories.
Yes.
I gotta put a giraffe on there.
Yes.
Yeah.
So he got a long neck.
Yeah.
He got a long neck because you bring a giraffe in the building like this, it won't work out.
Mm-hmm.
So if you do bring him in, he has to live like this here.
Mm-hmm.
He cannot. Every time the head go up and bumps, it hits the ceiling.
Yeah.
Now it only goes beyond 10, 11 foot. If a guy come up here 11 foot tall. Let go live 11. I think his head gonna be rubbing against that sheetrock up there.
Yeah, yeah.
But glory be to God for the gift. When we thank God, amen, for everything that is done, every good gift, amen, that coming down. Say what from the one, the Father of lights, from whom there's no barrenness, neither, amen, shadow of turning.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so as James begins to write, so he goes down and he deals with here, 21, he said, wherefore lay upon all filthiness, superfluous naughtiness, and receive with meekness the engrafted word, seed, which is able to save your soul.
Yes,
all right, all right.
You hear him again?
Yes,
the word which is able to save, amen, your soul.
Uh-huh.
So the life is full of temptations.
Yeah.
Yes,
we try this, amen, so you can try this. So it's full of pleasure. And things that we desire,
yes, Lord,
amen, to have in our lives.
Mm-hmm.
But he said, but anything, but we got to separate. It's like separation.
Come on, preacher.
Ourselves, amen, yes, for the filthiness.
Yeah.
Now, Peter picked it up. Said, now God is holy.
Yes, Yes, he is.
So we're talking about holy is where we have separation.
Yeah.
So we have to separate ourselves, amen, from all, amen, uncleanness.
Yeah.
And I mean, if we're faithful and just, then we confess the fault of him, he's faithful to forgive us from all our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness.
Well, yes, Lord.
But the chain goes on and marks it up. So the grafted word, we say engrafting. These tattoos. Uh-huh. You ever seen a tattoo on a person's arm? So, a lot of times, I saw my grandbaby last night. Papa, I got a tattoo. I said, what did you get the tattoo from? Your kid got these little plates.
Yeah.
He said, Papa, I just take this stuff, just wet it. Piece of paper, we used to do that a long time ago. Mm-hmm. And wet it and just and let it stay a while and put it up and then it'll stick to the skin.
Mm-hmm.
But this is washable.
Yeah.
You take water and wash it off.
Jesus.
But I'm praying it lies, amen. This is going to become a real thing. Put four frogs around him with marks all up on him.
Yeah.
A lot of times, see, our bodies are engrafted
with
all the marks and tattoos.
Yes,
but our lives be engrafted with the word of God.
Right.
So engrafted, some of you have met these people that put these tattoos up on you. They got this little fire like thing like a needle. And while they're going to that skin and doing all that stuff, it's painful.
Yeah.
And it's real sore.
Yes, sir.
And it's like somebody taking a branding iron.
Yes.
Y'all know what a branding iron is?
Yes.
These farmers beat them on their cattle, they brand them. And an iron gets real hot, not just hot, but red hot. Some of you have been scalded, amen, have been by fire, and some of you have a mark upon your body. When you touch that hot stone, you touch that grill, and then you realize you're red hot, and you look at your hand, you leave that mark up on your hand.
Yeah.
But what I'm saying, amen, about the branding iron and the word of God,
but
he's saying, amen, but receive in meekness. You know what meekness is? Meekness is not a word for humbleness.
Yeah.
And meekness and grab the word of God and so the word
Lord,
is
yes,
able
Lord.
To save
amen,
your soul.
Yes.
Why did I say the word is able to save your soul? Because if it's the word of God, amen, it's a lifesaver.
Yes, it is.
It's a roadmap from God.
Yes,
and then it'll take you right back, amen, from chapter 1 to Genesis in the beginning. It was God created, amen, the heaven and earth.
Yeah.
And it was God who began to set things in place. He gave us the greater life, and he gave us the lesser life. Didn't he?
Yes.
And then through it all, when it got through, he put the birds and the bees and flowers and trees and all such, amen, the good gift. Everything, this comes down from God.
Yeah.
And then chapter 2, when he get there, and he looked at it and he checked it out. And when he got finished looking at it, he said, it was good and very good.
Yes,
he said, okay, this is okay. This is proper. This is in its right place.
Uh-huh.
But then by that he said, now, okay, the animals are here, but I need something, amen, that I have to take care of what I have put here.
And then
by the time he said, okay, but let us make man. So he said, they're thinking the Holy Spirit, the Trinity is there. They're thinking that knowledge, okay, we need a human being down there. We need something that looks and shaped like us.
Right.
So in our image, amen. So God placed it there. But then look what he does. He takes dust, red dust, and then like a child takes some clay. Your child will play with clay, and they make different little things out of this clay.
Yes,
they make these little dogs and all the puppy like out of the clay.
Oh, yeah.
God does the same thing here. He takes that dirt like clay, and he fashions it. And the image, amen, it's a man. Like figure, something in the image of him.
Yeah.
Amen. But it's gonna become it's a flesh like thing, but you know God is a spirit.
Yeah.
Amen. Himself. But in the image, in the form of God.
Yes,
so that's what God has put within us. Amen. In the image, amen. So in other words, we have a mind, we can think. Amen. And then we have the knowledge.
Thank you, Lord.
Right.
So how did Adam, he knew how to replenish and do what he did? God directed him to do that. He showed him how to do what he wanted him to do. But we're grateful now, as he sent these gifts down, everything was perfectly and in place until you know who want to come and mess it up.
Yes, sir.
So sometimes I wonder, where did he come from?
Well.
Why the devil in the picture in the first place?
Well,
So God wanted here to replenish, multiply, do good. And the question might come up, why would such a creature replace him and make a new thing he did in that? And he brought sin upon us. So we can't question that. We know what the Bible says, amen, he was more subtle than all the creatures there. But I'm going to tell you where it comes from. With go to Revelation 19. When he got beside himself, God put him out.
Yes,
he snapped his tail.
Yes,
he snapped his tail, and then took out a third.
Uh-huh.
And then what did he go? He didn't go upwards because God is up there.
Yeah. Yeah.
You cannot go up, and only place you go is down. So he's looking for a place to go. Where can he go? What did the demon go this morning? It went into the swine.
Uh-huh.
He had to go to the swine so he looked for a home. So that is his job. Amen. He got to get into people's lives that he may trouble you, disturb your life. Amen. Amen.
Yes,
take control of your mind.
Yes,
make a new, because otherwise he wants to be a God himself.
Yeah.
So now, since he's here upon the earth, amen, he's become what? The God of this world.
Yeah.
Y'all heard what I'm saying?
Uh-huh.
So he's considered as what? The son of darkness.
Yes.
He's the one, he's like an angel, amen, in disguise. Amen. But he's a fallen angel. Amen. From heaven. So he's going to come and disrupt your life. But God has left us what? A roadmap.
Yes, he has.
God has given us, he's given us a plan.
Yes, yes.
Amen. Even he had a plan to send his own begotten son to this world, whosoever he believed in him, you should not perish, but that you may have, amen,
yes,
everlasting life.
Yes,
I'm going to get you. Amen. Take you on to a close. I went over by a few minutes here, but we want to try to put you on a mountain right
yes,
now.
Yes,
amen.
Yes,
talking about, amen,
thank
a doer, amen,
word.
Of the word of God.
Yes, yes.
Amen. Now, I believe if this hadn't happened when it happened, and when Adam and Eve did what they did, and here our great punishment comes upon them. Amen. So she's punished. Her punishment is, amen, this shall bruise his head, that shall bruise his heel. Amen. So, and by birth, you will be in labor. You shall have children. Amen. And with those kids, amen, pain.
Yeah.
And it's not now, he had told them at first, you're going to be fruitful and multiply. Some may think now, the kids didn't come in until the curse come. No. God already told them, be fruitful, multiply.
Yeah.
You're going to have the children anyhow.
Uh-huh.
But then it's something about what he brings here since that happened. He's going to be like an adversary.
Yeah.
He's going to be an enemy against you. So you've got to put up with him now.
Yeah.
All the days of your life.
Yeah, yeah.
So Adam, amen,
yeah,
you shall sweat
yes,
by your brow.
Uh-huh.
So nothing, amen, goes easy for you anymore. So the word, amen, for leaning and depending on me for your dependence, I won't be there.
Yeah.
Amen. The thorns and thistles, you shall walk upon the days of your life.
Lord,
so in this, amen, it brought us forth sweat and it brings us pain.
Yes.
Now
yes,
do we have the sweat and what we do and pain.
Yes, sir.
Comes up in our life.
Yes.
Pain, amen, through sickness.
Uh-huh. Yes.
Pain, amen,
yes,
in your birth and all
yes,
stuff.
Yes.
Pain, amen, when family members, amen, turn against one another and won't do right.
Uh-huh.
That's a pain right there.
Yes,
it will not just be a pain of sickness,
yes,
but be a pain, amen, when someone distrusts,
yes,
deceived, and all this stuff comes in our life, amen. And that hurts, man.
Oh, yes.
When everything, amen, just won't go perfect and good as we expect. So that's what you have it right there. It's here with us.
Yes, sir.
Yeah,
but
yeah,
guess
yeah,
what? Amen. Overcome.
Yes,
overcome.
Yeah. We can overcome this.
Yeah.
Because
yes,
God has made a plan.
Yes, he has.
Amen. God, amen, has sent.
Yes, he has.
Amen. The treasure map.
Yeah.
Yes, Lord.
This
yes,
is
Lord,
the treasure map.
Yes, it is.
Yes, it is.
Amen. To show us, amen, how to get there. Jesus died for us. But amen, for the self, amen, we learn to walk right and live right, that won't do us no good. Y'all hear what I'm saying?
Yes.
Yes, Christ died that you may have life. That's it. But if we want to obey the word of God, every man must live by, he told the devil, by the word of God. That's how man must live. So as we close this morning, James, here in the middle of this, before he goes for true religion, the test of obedience today. Do you find yourself, amen, out of time, we can plan to do, amen, certain things, say, well, okay, Lord, amen, I promise, I want to do that. In other words, never get to something, amen, you said you're going to do, and then you wind up going back on it.
Yeah.
A lot of times, sometimes, that's why we have to go to the Lord, amen, and you enforce your task. You want to be faithful and true to what you're doing.
Yes, sir.
Sometimes, amen, we try to maybe put off the day for tomorrow.
Yeah.
So, well, I can't do what I say I'm going to do for you today, but I got to put it off because I have other things that I'm going to have to do.
Yeah.
Let that be the last reserve.
Yeah.
Sometimes, amen, things may get between us that cause us to do nothing.